The wonderful thing about football is how creative it is. And this is why it has never caught on in America. You see, in America, the action is deliberately kept short so that the sponsors can get in as many commercials as possible. And also so that the players don't have to think for too long. They get instructions from the quarterback, who has, in turn, received them from the offensive coach. So no one has to think for themselves. This is the Dick Cheney version of creativity, otherwise known as doing exactly what you're told. So you get 4 seconds of extremely violent action, and then the only genuinely creative activity involved, a beer commercial. So, American football is played like a series of advertising jingles, while soccer is played like jazz. And while we're on the subject, why do the Americans insist on calling it soccer? Why do they have such a problem calling it football? It's a game played with a ball that is struck with the foot. Hence, football. You see? Are you following this, America? The clue is in the title. It's not that difficult. Whereas American football, as they call it, is a game where an object that's not really a ball at all, it's the wrong shape for a ball, is carried around by hand and occasionally thrown for other people to catch in their hands. You see? Only one person in each team is allowed to actually kick the ball, and they have to be specially brought onto the field to do it. I suppose, in its own way, that is a form of creativity. It's quite a creative use of language, you know, saying one thing and meaning something completely different.
They are so stupid that they have no idea how stupid they are. You see, if you're very, very stupid, how can you possibly realize that you're very, very stupid? You'd have to be relatively intelligent to realize how stupid you are. There's a wonderful bit of research by a guy called David Dunning at Cornell, who's a friend of mine, I'm proud to say, who's pointed out that in order to know how good you are at something requires exactly the same skills as it does to be good at that thing in the first place, which means, and this is terribly funny, that if you're absolutely no good at something at all, then you lack exactly the skills that you need to know that you're absolutely no good at it. And this explains not just Hollywood, but almost the entirety of Fox News.